So Raila Odinga Jr., I don't know what he's trying to do. Yeah. Nonga ile time niko nasema juu ya Charlene. Please shut the fuck up. If you're a kid of a billionaire, first of all, we can't relate with you. Unajua, we are not even in the same way mtoi wa millionaire. Acheki? Because having a million and being a millionaire are different. Unajua? A millionaire is a millionaire. You always have money, yes? Even at that level, you're a millionaire, we can't relate with you. Now try and imagine a billionaire.
Yeah.
So Raila Junior, ameanza hii ujinga fulani, ile everyone has been attacking Udem, anaitwa nani, Hanifa. So him is coming at it through, anapiga piga makona zake. So alibaki ameandika, okay, you are angry, but listen. See, the mobilization was done on platform, and that time it was all of us. I mean, it was everyone and anyone, and it was a lot. So is there a problem with asking? I've not said there's a problem, just seeking clarity.
Because I think kukoko level, if you are a Rao kid, just know anything in you. Yenye unaweza comment on political current affairs might impact either positively or negatively, even if it's a question directed to Hanifa. Unajua the vile utaiweka, how people will take it. She was receiving fires, ndio. I'm not taking anything like there's a lot she did that anybody couldn't do. I'm not even talking about time ya protest, time ya flood.
Yes.
Tayari flash mimi nilikuwa naruka tu maji viunzi na maji mimi naingia hapa na I tweet how bad the situation is, but she was there with these people, unaona, and I couldn't question her credibility because I wasn't doing shit. I was just retweeting. Na check yeye alikuwa pale kwa crown. Fast forward to nini, to this economic fight yenye alikuwa anasema ya nini, ya finance bill. She was in the forefront.
Yes.
Na check she, you know, she was fighting the cause yenye like we all believed in nanini, but I think as the nini progressed, people started noticing like there are people who are maybe gaining a lot of popularity, and maybe they felt most of them walikuwa gana smartphone kwa street, maybe they deserved something as well. No check, they felt like nobody's supposed to be singled out. In any movement, lazima uone like who's doing a lot of input, and maybe a lot of nini because of your time yake ya flat, they felt like she's an honest person they can trust, naweza nini anaweza channel fans zake, fans zao through hapo, but ikikam kwa nini kama hizo wewe peana tu, acha maswali mob na check sana sana. If you are, I would nini hizi nini a court of public opinion, eh? I can welcome their scrutiny, but if you are leader apo, your questions now in a poke more holes, na check.
Yeah,
and I felt like wase, like what the father had done, being an opposition leader for all that time, at least I'm not telling you to oppose, but also like footsteps to za budako, and then maybe you say me ni aje, my dad stood with the people na nini, there's someone who's young, you know, let me support by shutting the fuck up.
Yeah
una check.
So I think nani hiyo wasiwa kuona hiyo tweet unaweza tafuta Raila Junior. So kwa sababu juu tunaponga journey, tunaponga juu Raila Junior decided to get involved in the Hanifa debate. The Hanifa debate has been a very ugly debate because kuna people that I respected have ended up behaving in ways that I don't respect. And one of those people, of course, ni Gaitho. Like Gaitho, for Gaitho to attack her like that, like anyone who learns about M. Changa, the first thing that you learn about is no individual handles the money directly unless the money is for an individual project. Sindio? This M. Changa money was meant for victims. M. Changa, ama yu Mobi Changa, is a company that can be sued. So since they can be sued, they made sure that everything was above board. Because they also made a lot of money from it. I think they keep like 3%. They keep a lot of money from your door. Najivo? So they made around 1.3 million from this. So every shilling had to be accounted for. This girl went out of her way and accounted for it, then unapata mse kama nani Raila Odinga Jr. ameandika, you misunderstood, I've not mentioned Hanifa or the victims, God rest their souls. I also substituted, contributed, and no one told me because of my status I shouldn't. I ask blah blah blah, what's the minimum threshold for a document to be a certified audit? And pia mimi nasema, I ask Raila Odinga Jr., what's the minimum of me telling you to shut the fuck up? Because this is not your fight. Your father is a billionaire. As much as the reason why your father is a billionaire, we respect him, is because of the struggle that he went through. Yes. He was jailed, he was tortured, he was what? You've lived a very sheltered life. As Raila Odinga Jr., you don't know the reality of even sleeping hungry. These are things that you see. Sindio? You don't know even maybe the reality that I have blackout. When you make on a generator since you are a kid. Sindio? Sisi, like our reality and your reality are very different. As Raila Odinga Jr., if you are even stopped for offenses, your father's name can get you out of trouble. Sindio? Sisi, our father's name, we are literally the sons of nobody.
Might even put you in more trouble.
Yes. This girl, anaitwa Hanifa, ended up handling money that she'll never handle. Most probably she's never handled before. She handled 30 million. She dealt with a company called Mchanga. This company is licensed under Kenyan laws kusaidia contributions, and the contributions have to be legit. Unajua hivyo? You can't just start bullshit. And no one touched the money on an individual level. So why do you, as Raila Odinga Jr., tell us that Hanifa needs to work? What the fuck? This is the same thing being said by Abrams Mutai. At least one thing ile na respect nani nayo, na respect Gaido nayo, is Gaido actually came out clearly. Akasema jose kwa kilia hii do, because he didn't touch the money. Him, he wanted to touch the money. And, but you know.
Yeah, do you think that dude, that did, I think, he's been all about the money. Because I think kuna time, time what would kuna uliza about Gio Bonnie and nini. So maybe there's some commentary make. Kasemati, I say, ni kama wali get. This is not the first time he's talking about money. By the way, for him, it's an economic fight, you guys.
Yes. Hey, eventually, and he's come out. He's come out clear.
It's an economic fight. of which, and I feel like the NGO fraternity, hai baka idea zake. Ama kama ilikuwa na yeye, alafu ikamtema. Ama maybe vitu zake as get funding. Nacheki kwa time, alisema like, hey, kwani mimi, you know. What is one? So
alilia
mbaya tu. But I admire his honesty.
Like to have pretended for such a long time that it was about the revolution and then to come out and say alafu, but the reason me so sema na admire is the fact that this money is being handled by Mchanga. If it's going through Mchanga, you'd not have gotten the money, and the fact that you want to lie to yourself that ungepata hii do, it's stupid, you know, it's stupid. Let me see your kitu yake. So I don't see why. Because hata hapa utapata ame retweet Raila Odinga Jr. This is after insulting Raila Odinga. You understand? Like, so he's confused. He come to his story, and I don't know. But your story. Because hata yeye mwenyewe unajua hizi accusations zinakuaga. So kuna raia anaitwa DJ Carlos Mrema ilianga ile pesa Francis Gaido alikula ya Jimmy Wanjigi ni kama imeanza kuisha, bazu ameanza kukonda, then Joe Gaido, wewe umbwa tulipewa na wewe. And when I see this, because vile nashindaga nikisema Gaido ni mse nimemjua for very long, over 10 years, and easy fights amekuwa kifight juu ya do, like zimeni surprise kabisa, it's not something I expected from him.
Jana kuna mse ali highlight akasema ile time kulikuwa na maandamano. No, ni wa Kimani alikuwa hapa. Anaitwa Kimani ama this guy mwenye alisema he felt attacked akiwa hapa.
Paulo Kimani, yes.
Paulo Kimani. Alisema watu wakitokea nini? Watu wakitokea kufight against whatever, this the bill. yalitokea na t-shirt ya vote, it's due either 2027.
Oh, okay. Mm.
So maybe pia ilikuwa ni he also trying to nini to attract guys for Mchanga. So maybe hata nini for
because this is post on Monday. So on Monday, guys walikuwa wameandika a drunk Boniface Mwangi just so happened to be at the airport on the same day his benefactor William Ruto was leaving for China. Msikio? In the pursuit of clout, he antagonized a helpless traffic officer, perhaps fueled by guilt, to compensate for his inconsistency and duplicity. Mm. If you listen to Bonnie these days, he sounds drunk most of the time with incoherent talking points because he hopped onto a course he didn't envision and wrecked it from within. Kenyans, in their infinite stupidity, sent him, Maskia, and Hani Farsafi loads of money inadvertently killing movement's momentum. Even as Boni and Hanifa mobilized people to leave CBD and discouraged Occupy State House on behalf of the state without any honor, blah, blah, blah. So this is what I have a problem with. Like, uni gaidu, uni mse naheshimu. So Boni amefikishwa kotini this week, sindo? I think this week is the week he was freed. Mm-hmm. The minute that he came out, alikuwa naambia Ruto nini? Protest or not, whatever. Mm. Alafu, Boni ule amelipua na Ruto.
Mm.
Yes?
Yeah.
Alienda airport kuita Ruto muizi. Ruto alilipa Boni akuja airport kuita muizi.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yo ni ungwana.
Common sense is not common anymore.
Yeah. Just plus, bullshit. I think ule mse, ana, I think wale wase, if I'm paying you, your story will be consistent. Ata ita change.
Mm-hmm.
Check if I'm paying you.
Yes.
So, a guy though, akuna post yake ukosa. A guy nini? Boni na Do.
Yes.
Boni Do. Hanifa Do.
Mm.
Na check. Watu walitoka, watu waliacha, watu waliacha, aliambia watu watoka tao kwa nini? Do. Nani sijui vote, whatever. Do.
Mm.
Na check.
Mm.
Ah, si wengi, ame atako si wengi sana. So, me, I don't know. I don't know what his issue is. But sasa now, if ukakachini, na ukakachini and then you listen to uangalia post za Boni, na uangalia post za Gaido. Like,
yeah.
You could actually see Mali influence ya Do yiko.
Mm. Yeah, one side is all about the money.
One side is, you know. Ata ukaulizo, maybe nani ameliupo uko like, yo mse.
Kuzata nini, kitu moja ile Gaido anafaa kujua.
Mm.
History ya watu ku, the reason why people ended up sending Hanifa a lot of money, according to me, is because of two people. It's because of Gaido na Abrahams Mutai. And the reason is, when you attack an innocent person, who people can clearly see in is innocent so much, people end up now, watu wanakuambia, sikia kiwaru. Acheki.
Yeah.
Hii dido ya Mchanga, hii ya nina kuwaga do hard. Like, there has to be accountability. So, you as an individual never touch it. And that's why, wasa walianza kuiba hiyo do ni mahosi. Naka kutende mahosi? Siko zina send fake bills, eh? Mm. Wansikia tira hiyo metandikuwa risasi ya rasa. Wasa wanatafuta, blah, blah, blah. Acheki. Alafu, talking of, nini, watu kupigwa risasi, most probably next week tutakuwa na a survivor wa protest. Kuna msali pigwa risasi ya kichwa na aka survive.
Yeah.
Most probably tutakuwa na yeye next week. So make sure you look out for that interview. And yeah. I'm totally pigwa jo risasi. Jo ilingia kwa kichwa but yeah. Survived. So I think after he survived, alikuwa eko nene. So tutakuwa na yeye next week.
He stopped a bullet.
Yeah. So that's it. But...